great performance by you in a back-to-back. Was it the return of the dinner plate? Was that what the secret was?
It was the return of the dinner plate. That's big time. You know, sometimes I just feel like having some healthy food after, and I'd bring my own. That's how the whole thing started. Actually, I've been doing it for years, just sometimes I haven't been caught on camera doing it. So this is actually nothing new, but it is funny, and so I roll with it.
Everyone on the internet always speculates what's in there because it's always covered in foil. So can you give us a little secret as to what it was tonight?
It's actually, today it was some brown rice. It was some coconut curry chicken and some broccoli. So just, you know, I try to eat very healthy and otherwise, you know, you just got to keep this old friend going somehow.
You're closing in on 30,000 points. You're only a couple of hundred points away. You know, what will that mean to you when you do reach that milestone?
I mean, honestly, it's been an incredible ride. You know, when I first got here, I was 20 years old, didn't really know what to expect. And my first year was really, really tough. I didn't even know if I was going to make in this league. So, you know, whatever, 19 years later, to pass some of these legends on the all-time scoring list, it's been an incredible, almost surreal experience, you know. But like I always say, I think it's going to really mean so much to me once my career is over. Once I look back, maybe show my kids, show my grandkids, then I think it's going to sink really in. Right now, I'm still competing, I'm still battling out there, and hopefully play healthy hopefully next year.
The hallmark of your game has obviously been the beautiful jump shot, you know, the step back. Every other guy in the league now seems to be adapting to that. But there's one part of your game that's also carried through, and that's the hops. And we saw that in Mexico City a couple of weeks ago. You got up there and threw one down. I mean, what happened? Was it the Mexican air? What was it?
I think I blacked out. I don't know what happened. Right now it's just, it's hard as I got older. I was never really an athletic player. So, you know, that's obviously the first thing that goes as you get older. You know, your lateral movement, you know, the breaks when you run forward, and also obviously the hops. It does help that I'm 7 feet sometimes, and I just got up there and I punched it in, and that was awesome.
You're saying we're probably not going to see you in the dunk contest this year, even though Zach LaVine's pulled out, there is an opening there. You think that's pretty much the only award you haven't won?
You know, a couple years ago, when I really was on top of my game, I always said my goal was to win the slam dunk contest, the three-point contest, and the skills challenge. And I never got invited to the dunk or to the skills. But hey, maybe next year I'll be hopeful.
It's a year ago tomorrow for the famous Ellen haircut. What happened there? Were you going to bring out something this year for us?
We always do with my family. We do this vision board thing, what the new year can bring. And so for last year, I said, I want to try something new. I want to try a new haircut. So I looked through this magazine, this style magazine, and I saw this one haircut. I was like, this model had this haircut. I was like, I think it's going to look good on me. And then once I pulled it off, you should have seen the day I walked in here and the entire team just turned around. Oh, man, I got all red and stuff. And that was embarrassing.
Anytime those guys have got an MVP, a championship and scored 30,000 points, then they can come and talk to you. Until then, though, they've got to keep quiet, I think.
Go. I like that.
Dirk, thanks very much for your time. Good luck for the rest of the season, man.
Appreciate it. Thanks for having me.